In this episode of the AI Show, we hear from Kun Ying, Senior Program Manager on the Microsoft Azure Cognitive Services team. Kun will show us how to use the Anomaly Detector with simple REST API calls that you can put into your own application today. Make sure you tune in.
Hi, I'm Kun, Program Manager in Microsoft. I'm going to use 10 minutes to share with you this exciting AI-powered API service, Anomaly Detector, which is able to detect anomalies from time series using just simple REST API calls. Hopefully, after this 10 minutes, you walk away with a basic understanding of how you could build your time series monitoring solutions with Anomaly Detector, and more importantly, where to find more resources. I'll start with a really quick overview and then spend most time on code demos and wrap up my video with the links to more resources. Anomaly Detector is detecting anomalies from time series using AI, but you don't need to know AI to use it because it's just three REST APIs. What you do is just to call the APIs with an array of time series data points. The APIs will immediately respond with which data points are anomalous, which ones are change points. No training with labeled data is needed. No model selection, no model deployment. Anomaly Detector exposes that simplicity by hiding complexity. It is leveraging a collection of cutting-edge models and a mechanism that automatically select the best performing algorithm in samples based on the hidden patterns in your data. No matter its seasonality, trend change, random spikes, and so on and so forth, it just works. It could adapt to all sorts of those data patterns. Now let's just jump to the code demo. The first step is to create an Anomaly Detector resource by searching for Anomaly Detector Microsoft in Azure Marketplace, and then you just create the Anomaly Detector resource. I've already created one. The point here is you need to go to the resource portal and copy the endpoint as well as one of the API keys. You will need to use them in your code. I've mentioned the three REST APIs. Now I'm going to show you three Jupyter notebooks, namely the anomaly detection for batch data and the anomaly detection for streaming data and the change point detection. I'm going to walk you through the code. Previously, we've copied the API key and endpoint. Now you need to replace that in order to run this code. I've replaced the API key and the endpoint. Now let's look at the code. So this is the function that's calling the REST API as defined by this endpoint. It is posting data to the endpoint with the API key in the header. Then let's check how the data is being passed into this function. Basically, it's just loading the JSON data from file, add some parameter here, and call this build figure function, which starts with calling this detect function with the data. The code here is basically taking the result, which is the return from the API call, and draw a chart with it. Let me just run everything. In this first sample, you could see that although the trend is changing, but these are not detected as anomalies, whereas these spikes are correctly marked as anomalies. And in the second example, although there is seasonality, the API service is able to adapt to the seasonality, understand the seasonality, and take these data points as normal ones, while this one doesn't really conform to the regular pattern, is detected as anomaly. This is very useful when your data has something like 7 days seasonality. And you will notice that there are multiple charts for each data set. The difference is about the sensitivity. Here we're using 95. This is making the service really sensitive to anomalies. So this blue shade here, which is the boundary, the lower bound and the upper bound is very narrow comparing to the next one, which is using 90 sensitivity, and the last one, which is using 85. Now let's jump to the second Jupyter notebook. This is the latest point anomaly detection with /last API. The same as before, you need to replace the right API key and endpoint here. I've replaced those. Now let's run and check the code. In this notebook, data is loaded here, and then this code is trying to build a sliding window of data points. In total, 29 data points are used to call the detect function and to detect anomalies. And the result is only about whether the last data point being passed in is anomalous or not. And as you can see, there's no result before this point. This is because these points are basically used as the sliding window, and this is the first window of data. And the sensitivity parameter could be still used in this case. To better help you understand this, I'm going to show you a demo application instead of code to help you understand what a sliding window really is when you want to build a magic monitoring solution that's monitoring your streaming data. This is the demo web app built up on Anomaly Detector APIs. I've already replaced the endpoint and the API key here. Now I'm selecting this sample one and I'm going to click start. As you can see, there's this gray shade, gray moving window here, and this is the sliding window that I'm talking about. As you can see, in this request input, an array of data points is being passed to the API endpoint. And this is exactly what's in this sliding window. And the response is only about whether the last data point is anomalous or not. Now let's look at the third Jupyter notebook, which is the change point detection example. For the sake of time, I've already replaced the endpoint and the API key here. This sample also first loads data from a JSON file and then called the buildFigure function. And this buildFig function, of course, called this detect function with the API key and the data. And this detect function is just simple HTTP call. The starting point of a trend change is detected and marked as green. Now, in all those samples, we are loading data from JSON files. What do those JSON files look like? This is just one sample, and the other ones are pretty much the same. The main part of it is really an array of timestamp and value pairs. You can pass in a few other parameters. Granularity is one of them. For details, you need to check the API specification. Now, what about container? I'm not going to do a comprehensive demo on container because it's pretty much the same thing, at least the same usage. I have a Docker container of anomaly detector that's running in my laptop with the API key and the billing endpoint, exactly the same that I'm using for the other demos. Now I'm going to change the endpoint in the Jupyter notebook. First, it should be HTTP instead of HTTPS. And the API endpoint now change to this. I'm going to clear the output and run again. Here we go. That's it. Remember to replace this. And API key doesn't matter really. I can input anything because this container in the backend is already using the API key of your anomaly detector resource. Therefore, in your code, you can use anything and it doesn't change the result whatsoever. All right, so much for the demo. These are the resources that you could find useful after this session. knowing when something really goes off the rails is incredibly important. And now it could be easily done with just simple API calls. I'm really excited about our service. What about you? Let us know and feel free to try out Anomaly Detector and start to build with Anomaly Detector. Thank you.